Hi, I'm Sylvia Henderson, your idea coach at youridea.com. I help you make your impact one idea at a time. In my book, Hey, That's My Idea, I teach a six-stage process that helps you clarify, structure, and act on your ideas. I use the mnemonic IMPACT to define the process since we want our ideas to have an impact on our businesses and our lives. The fourth stage of this impact process begins with the letter A. It stands for attention, command it. From the first three stages of the impact process, you have a structured idea and an implementation strategy. Part of your strategy includes getting your idea success team, people who support you, on board with your idea. To get their support, you've got to get their attention. This is basic to presenting and communicating messages. It's said that great minds think alike, but when it comes to presenting your ideas to different people, each brain couldn't be more different. And that's why it's important to understand how to reach each person and to command his or her attention. If they're not paying attention to you, then they can't listen to you or understand and support your idea. So let's look at three ways to evaluate your audience so you can command their attention. Number one way is through demographics. Demographics can include information such as age and gender, ethnicity, religion, socioeconomic status, political preferences, levels of education, so much more. When you understand the demographics of an audience, you have insight into what shapes their experience and what the hot buttons are that command their attention. Demographic data can also help you avoid offensive remarks and avoid topics that don't relate to or are unappreciated by your audience. The second way to command their attention is through studying their behaviors. Behaviors reflect how your target audience communicates, thinks, responds to suggestions, reacts to change, and they move to action. You can convey your idea in ways that they relate to and that they embrace. Best of all, analyzing their behavior helps you anticipate what motivates and discourages your audience so that they'll listen and be compelled to act. The third way to command their attention is through their needs. For example, a C-level decision maker is more likely to respond favorably to overviews and summaries that highlight bottom line results, whereas financial backers want to see numbers and a return on investment. These are two different people that you may want on your idea success team, and each has a different need to be met. You serve people best when you target and meet their needs. When you present identical information to every audience in exactly the same way, you may save a little bit of time, but you take a costly shortcut that cheats you out of the results you desire. So evaluate your target audience's demographics, behaviors, and needs in order to command their attention. You'll discover what motivates them and how you can hit those motivators to help your idea take flight. If you're an entrepreneur or even a dreamer looking to change your life, I help you get clear about, organize, and implement your ideas. So go to youridea.com, no S, focus on one idea at a time, for tools and strategies that you can apply right away as my gift to you. Stay connected to me, Sylvia Henderson, for your idea journey.